Hi everyone, I'm Jade, you're watching Up and Atom, and today we're talking about NASA's latest discovery, the TRAPPIST-1 solar system. What is it? How was it discovered? And what makes it one of the most exciting discoveries in the search for life beyond Earth? 40 light years away in the constellation of Aquarius, 7 Earth-sized exoplanets have been discovered. This is the largest amount of Earth-sized planets that have ever been found around a single star. The star was actually found in May 2016 and given the name TRAPPIST-1 after the Transiting Planets and PlanetesImals small telescope in Chile. Not quite sure where the eye comes from, but let's just go with it. The way in which this solar system was found is actually quite fascinating. The TRAPPIST-1 star glows brightest in the infrared, meaning that its wavelengths are too long to be detected by the eye. It was detected by an infrared telescope called the Spitzer and monitored for 500 hours. The radiation from the TRAPPIST-1 star would periodically dim and brighten again, meaning that a planet could be passing in front of it, blocking some of its light. By measuring these dips in radiation, NASA scientists calculated the size of each planet in the TRAPPIST-1 solar system. By measuring the spacing between these dips, they were also able to calculate how long it took each planet to complete an orbit. The lengths of these orbits then told the scientists the distance each planet was from the TRAPPIST-1 star. The longer a planet took to orbit, the further it was from the star. The planets were calculated to be very close together, so close in fact that their orbits interacted with one another because of the gravitational pull. This pull meant that the planets' orbits were slightly less regular than what NASA scientists had predicted they would be, based on the planet's size and distance from their star. Using this difference between the actual and predicted orbitals, they were able to calculate the mass of the 6 inner planets. Because density is just mass divided by volume or size, they were able to estimate the density of each planet, which gave a pretty good indication of what the planet is made up of. The reason this is all so exciting is because all 7 planets have been deemed suitable for supporting liquid water, the key to life as we know it. 3 planets in particular lie in the habitable or Goldilocks zone, with conditions being just right for watery oceans. Over 3,500 exoplanets have been found, and of these, only a tiny fraction of those have been deemed suitable for life. And here we find 7 all in the same solar system. NASA scientists speculate that the main reason water could exist in this solar system is the TRAPPIST-1 star itself. The star is an ultracool dwarf, the least massive star at a 12th of the size of our sun. This means that the exoplanet's orbits are relatively short, ranging from 1.5 to 20 days. Science mission director Thomas Zurbuchen said that if our sun were the size of a basketball, the TRAPPIST-1 star would be the size of a golf ball. The star is also less than half the temperature of our sun at a brisk 2,277 degrees Celsius. This means that planets orbiting very close to it could still sustain liquid water, and indeed they are orbiting very close, with all exoplanets closer to the TRAPPIST-1 star than Mercury is to our sun. Because all the exoplanets are bunched up so close to their star, this also means they are very close to each other. So if you were standing on one of the 7 exoplanets, you would be able to see features of neighboring planets, much like we can see the craters of the moon from Earth. Based on the data so far, the 6 inner planets are predicted to have rocky surfaces, with the 7th speculated to be an icy snowball. Another consequence of their close proximity is that the exoplanets could potentially be tidally locked to their host star. This would mean that the same side of the planet is always facing the star, a perpetual day on one side and a perpetual night on the other. You wouldn't need to worry about getting sunburnt though, because the ultracool star shines 200 times dimmer than our sun, so more of a perpetual twilight than perpetual day. So what next in the search for life in the TRAPPIST-1 solar system? NASA scientists plan to use transmission spectroscopy to study the composition of the 7 exoplanets. They are also currently putting up more telescopes to study 1,000 of the nearest ultracool dwarfs and to see if there's any exoplanets surrounding them. Whether or not we find life, it's a giant step toward finding out whether we're alone in the universe. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to give this video a like if you liked this video, and subscribe because I put out new physics videos every second week. Thank you. Bye.